I've got a little grove here, citrus grove. This is my little one through hell and back. You know, they've had a battlefield going on. They've settled down. They've since taken off. But the only one that hasn't done well is this little one here. It's my little Karakara orange. See all this dieback? Now, there's a number of reasons for that. A, no water. And we talk about citrus trees not wanting water, but this one needs some water. B, we've had the rabbits digging holes here. Look at all the rabbit poo. See all that? They constantly dig underneath here and expose the roots of the plant. So they've put a little bit of stress into this tree. Well, not a little bit, a lot. We had these moss when we first planted them. We had a good layer of pea straw all the way around, and it's blown away. That's how high the winds are across here. Citrus trees don't like high winds, but coupled with excessive moisture kills them. But in this case here, there's been no water. But if I have a close look, a couple of days of rain, I can see new growth coming on already over here. Not these ones here, they've fallen off. But this dieback has to be taken off. So if you have got dead, diseased, damaged wood on your citrus trees or any fruit tree, and in actual fact, any plant at all, get out there and clean them up like I'm doing now with this little one here. I'm gonna take all this off, clean it up, make it look nice and pretty, mulch it up, and more importantly, drop some irrigation down here because I don't get out here often enough. So I need to irrigate this garden bed because as you can see from the other ones, they've got irrigation and they've all got their new growth coming on already. They cop the same wind, the same conditions as this little one here, but because it's got no irrigation on it, it's struggled. A little bit of EcoBoost and liquid gold will go a long way as well. Marisi.